I said I was working on a catering trailer selling burgers and flipping burgers outside of the Sunderland football ground. And, you know, then I went to the Olympics and it changed my life around. And then I was really smart with the money that I did earn. I used to buy houses. Every two fights, I'd buy a house. Now I own five houses in the UK. So I invested my money really wisely. And then when the company opened a gym here, I invested the rest of my money into box and burn. And you know, and being smart about it, which is a lot of boxers, a lot of athletes really, really struggle with, is to do that. You know, there's a lot of boxers that don't pay tax, which is a terrible idea. You know, and when I turned pro, I was like, not a chance. Am I working all this hard, getting all these punches in the face to earn this money to pay 30-40% of it to a tax? That, I'm not doing that. But you know, then I got wise to it and I realized, you know, there's ways around it. Paying less tax, but as long as you're paying tax. I know fighters, I know one fighter, he was a British champion. He earned, I think, £30,000 for his fight, which is about $50,000. And after that fight, because he'd never paid any tax running up to that, he had a $50,000 tax bill. So he had to put everything that he earned from this 12-round war British title fight, he had to pay it to the tax man or he was going to go to jail, you know? And fighters make that mistake of not paying tax. And then not investing the rest of the money, you know, it's pretty crazy to me. But you know, of course, what it is with fighters, we come from backgrounds where uneducated backgrounds. Fighters are known for being uneducated and not having good people around them, smart people around them, and not having a business mind, just a fighter. So when you get someone like that who's got money, who's getting a bit of money, you know, they don't know what to do with it. They'll spend it on a flash car with big wheels, which I did that as well. But you know, and they'll throw it all away. I always had a good business brain. Like I said, I bought the catering trailer and started working on that.
Oh, that was your own company?
Yeah, it was my own
Okay.
van. I was 19-year-old, didn't have a clue what I was doing, never cooked a burger in my life. But I thought, this is a good idea. I got it, pulled outside, no permits or anything, just started flipping burgers. And I was making like $500 on a weekend, and then training throughout the week. I was making more money than any other amateur boxer at the time. You know, and it really helped. It paid off, and then yeah, it was my idea to invest in houses and properties, and then obviously come over here and take the big risk of putting the rest of the money that I had into an empty warehouse in Santa Monica. I'd only been in LA for like 6 months. I didn't have a clue about the market or about renting the building, but I put the rest of my money into a property, and you know. Now we'll pay it off. Now we've got two gyms, education program. So, yeah, I mean, that's the thing. And then what I see, like, so back to the point about boxers, they'll get the money and they'll spend it, and they'll think it's going to come forever. Then they'll get an injury or something will happen. They've got to retire from boxing. The career's ended, and now they're not getting that money keep coming in, you know. And then, and they get depressed, start drinking, get a job on a building site. Because they've got no education, and what I'm seeing right now happens all the time. They get a little bit punch drunk because they've been fighting all their life. They've got a little bit of CTE, and they're living a really, really bad life. That's the what I've just described there is the path of a fighter. Start when they're 10 years old, retire when they're 26. They've got no money. They don't know what to do. They've got no education. They get into a shit job, start drinking, get fat, get depressed. The life, you know, and this is something that I'm trying to do with our Boxing Burn Academy, our education program. I love to help boxers make money through teaching boxing, because that when I said that I haven't got an education, that's a lie. They haven't got a school education, they've got a boxing education. You know what I mean?
No, completely.
They've got the experience to be able to be a good coach. Like, I know basketball is different; it's more specific about winning games and all that. But with boxing. This, I think this is the only really sport where you can teach it as a part of fitness, everyday fitness. I might be wrong, there might be some more. But now if they're going to take that boxing knowledge and learn how to be a fitness trainer, combine them two together, they've got a money-making thing right there by teaching boxing for fitness. But like you say, everyone can't do that. But with our program, that I'm teaching people how I did that, now I understand how to speak to someone who wants to learn boxing for fitness rather than learn boxing to fight, you know?
Yeah.
To translate that, because that's the big thing in the fitness industry with boxing. So a big thing is what boxers do. And I was the same when I turned from being a professional boxer to teaching for in the fitness industry. We try and make every student perfect. Like someone comes in, they can't do a proper jab. It's like, no, you need to do this. No, you need to do this. No, you need to. And we talk to them the way our old school boxing coaches talk to us, mm-hmm. right? Where what the boxers need to understand is the number one thing people need to be getting out of the session is enjoyment, fun, right? Now, if someone comes in for a boxing session, then the trainer, the boxer, should make sure that they have fun, a lot of fun. The second thing that they should be getting is having a great f***ing workout, right? The third thing that they should be getting is learning a new skill, boxing.
Mm-hmm.
Now, if you get number one and three mixed up, if you try and teach them how to box perfect, what that's going to do for 99% of people who's coming to boxing for fitness is going to take the fun out of it. It's going to make it f***ing boring. That's a big thing a big mistake that boxers trying to get in the fitness industry make when they're trying to teach someone for fitness, you know?
Mm.
And as well, like, my coach, if I made a mistake, Tony, what was that? Right? If I said that to one of these housewives in Santa Monica, Sally, what the was that? She's not coming back to the gym. Or if I drop my hand, I get a slap across the face. Again, if I did that with one of these lawyers who come in to box and burn, drops his hand, whack across the face, he's not coming in again.
You might have a lawsuit on your hands.
Exactly, exactly, especially in this town. So we can't do that. But what I can do is, that was good, but if you do it this way and speak to them in a different manner, that was excellent. But when you do it like this, you're going to get this benefit, like this, you know? Another thing, what boxers have when they're teaching boxing is that they've got an ego. Like, and I was the same. I'd be in the gym and I'd be saying, this boxing trainer over here has never boxed a day in his life. How can he teach someone how to box? Yeah. And his client looks and he should be doing this, he should be doing that. It's a bit of an ego, like, and he's getting paid for that. Nah, you know? We've got to lose that completely.
Mm-hmm.
We've got to lose that computing. Now we've got trainers at Box and Burn earning 2-3 grand a week teaching boxing who's never had a pair of gloves on in their life, but they understand how to teach our methods, how to speak to a client, how to make sure they're having a good time with boxing. They're not training someone to fight in the Olympics or for a world title. They're teaching someone boxing. They give them a great workout, make them addicted to the workout, and the person's loving it, getting good results. The trainer's enjoying it, earning money. It's a win-win all around. And yeah. Like I say, that's a big thing. What athletes, especially boxers, do, that have that ego, you know, thinking, no, you can't do it.